Just have a show of hands so the presenters who are here so that we know that all of you are present and we can, you know, cue them. So Avatar, can I see Avatar? Okay. Then, yeah, GPS Private Limited, Sri Lanka, okay. Apurv.
Apurv was here.
Must be having desert, okay. Punjab Digital Library, okay. Spiel Studios. Disha, okay. Then Vimanika, okay. So there's only one person missing. So we'll have you all had the opportunity to put your presentations into the system, or do you have to do it? Could you please do that quickly so that we don't delay later? Shall we commence as Syed, do we have your Syed there? No. Okay. Well, good afternoon and welcome to this session. We've got 7 presenters. I'm one of them who probably will join us, who's not here right now. My name is Rajan Varada. I am one of the founding trustees of the India Heritage Cities Network, a network of, it has been funded by UNESCO, and it basically looks at bringing in the element of preserving culture and heritage in city planning. It's a network of various cities. It's just started very recently. And since you are in this space, please do go on to the UNESCO site and also the IHCN site and see it. Let me also apologize on behalf of Nicole Bolomi, who's also my colleague in UNESCO. She's down with a wonderful fever from Delhi, which is going around called chikungunya. I hope you all don't get it, but so her apologies to you all. Mrs. Sanyal joins me to kind of stand in her shoes, and let us take the session forward. May I invite Avatar to make their first presentation? Avatar from Karnataka State Road Transport Corporation.
You can take 5 to 7 minutes.
7 minutes, yeah.
Then after the presentation, we'll have a few questions.
Yeah, do you have a presentation?
Yes, sir.
Okay, yeah, you can go there, no problem.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Rajkumar. I'm Director of Operation from Karnataka State Road Transport Corporation. This is a presentation on our advanced reservation system called as Avatar. Avatar is advanced anywhere, anytime advanced reservation. This was first introduced in Bangalore proper in Karnataka state in 1987 as an online reservation system with a lot of limitations. Then it progressed. One step happened in 1992, another one in 1997. The one we are presently using is the 2006 introduction of Avatar. So as the name itself suggests, you can book seats from anywhere in the world on Karnataka Transport Services. From here, is it? Yeah, thank you. See, this was a web-based passenger seat reservation system introduced in 2006, enabling inquiries about bus routes, bus schedules to do ticket reservation from anywhere to anywhere, and provides a lot of functionalities and features to bring in a lot of convenience in bus travel. This is now being done through three main channels. We have what we call as counter booking, which are physically located centers in Karnataka and also 5 neighboring states. And then we have e-booking. You can book on the internet. And then we also have mobile booking. You can also book seats on mobile. Hello?
Yeah.
This has a lot of interfaces, as you can see, starting from that one. Ours is the first state transport undertaking in India to bring this convenience to the passengers. As you know, it's web-based. We do e-booking. We also allow credit and debit card facility and mobile booking, as I said. Yeah. Sorry for this interruptions. If you can see the growth in the reservations, it's, I would say, is very, very encouraging. In 07-08, we did booking worth, let's say, about 153 crores, then grew to 183 plus 18 there. The blue one is the booking on internet. The pink one is the online reservation counters, physical counters. Then the third 09-10 figure is the latest one. The growth rate, as you can see, from 07-08 to 09-10, 5.4, 10.2, and 18% growth. There are 553 counters spread all over Karnataka and also five neighboring states. Then mobile also, as I said, is available as a venue, I mean channel of booking. And there are 1.2 million registered users as of now, not only from India, from all over the world. And a lot of people do visit for reservation purpose and a lot of other information. We also give SMS alerts to passengers on mobile. To that extent, the comfort level, we think, increases enormously. And we also, I mean, this is done through capturing mobile information. When passengers book seats, we also collect mobile their mobile numbers, and we send SMS messages to them. And in case of delays, our conductor talks to the passenger who has booked and who has not come. So that comfort of that level of comfort is there. Then who are the beneficiaries of the project? They are basically bus commuters, first of all, then franchises who do booking for us, then government service providers. Bangalore One is a government service provider. They have their own centers and they also do booking for us. And then there are master franchises who do booking from multiple channels, and our own management has its own benefits in administering depots, head office, then senior management level, information for senior management level, finance and revenue also has benefits, then ticket inventory is again a subsystem. Coming to bus commuters, the segments involved are general citizens, women, children, special passengers, handicapped and all that. Then among special passengers, we have senior citizens, police personnel, elected representatives who make use of these services. An analysis of the trend, we see a majority of booking happens in the premier segment, as you can probably guess. In our case, it is what we call as well-worn Rajamsa services. Nearly 80 to 90% of our bookings happen for these services. So it has, in another way, has given a sort of lift to the service. The convenience of reservation also helps you to grow. These are the various awards given to us: National E-Governance Award, M-Billion South Asia Awards of 2010 Congress, Golden Peacock Innovative Product Service Award, and also Indian Express Media Innovation Award. people, analysis by Google has shown that more than 100, I mean, people from more than 160 countries reserve seats. We have 30% advance reservation. A lot of people before coming here book and then buy tickets here. If you see the growth, you can see under the services covered, it was initially 1,200. Now it has grown to 2,460. And the number of seats booked has increased from 10,000 when the system was introduced to 20,000 now. Average revenue is 22 lakhs to 80 lakhs. Then e-bookings, which was zero when it was introduced in 2006, has now gone up to 4,000. Then e-booking revenues alone per day comes to 20 lakhs. Number of registered users, more than 12 lakhs. Karnataka, users covered, of course, earlier it was only Karnataka, and now it is worldwide. And seat booking counters has been increased in a big way from 125 to 553. As value additions, we have, we can earn revenues through advertisement on pre-printed tickets. We can also have mobile booking used for revenue earning purpose, again advertisements. This integration with Bangalore One also gives us a lot of exposure and also big numbers. And then SMS alerts also gives a lot of comfort, as I said, to passengers. This system, because of its convenience and all that, has been replicated in other issues in Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Maharashtra, Gujarat. Sustainability is high-end data center with state-of-the-art facility we have. Reliability, there is no problem. The passenger base is increasing in a big way. We have disaster recovery site to take care of hitches. And then employment. As we have physical counters, it does provide employment. Each counter typically means about three persons can work. Then unique offerings are, you have this seat layout displayed, available. You can choose your seat in the computer screen itself. There are seats reserved for women, seats reserved for senior citizens. Then you can book both onward and return journey tickets, for which you also get a discount. You can do group booking again, for which you also get a discount. As we move forward, the plan is to sustain the current pace of growth over a long period of time. We now have a system devised for about 1,000 simultaneous use, and we intend to grow it to 5,000. And also we want to increase the counters in a big way, both in our state and the neighboring state. And we also want to have GPS-based passenger information center for better information. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Is there any question? Quick question?
Yeah, any questions?
We can take questions after every presentation.
So what is the discount for return journey? In our case, it is 10% discount.
And group?
Group is 5% discount, where you book four or more than four seats in a single transaction.
So group is taking for return journey, then it will be cumulative?
No, separate.
Separate.
Okay.
Any other question?
Senior citizens, we have 25% discount for senior citizens. Yeah. For those above 60 years, you will get a discount of 25% in fare.
Any other?
5 plus 10% return.
No. For senior citizens,
total
it is 25%
discount.
It's not 25% or 10% plus 10% or plus 5.
No.
It's 25. Because 25 itself is significant.
Want somebody at the back?
No. No, no. We don't charge for that. What we typically do is, when we want, I mean, when they want this knowledge from our side, we do charge a fee, a one-time fee.
I think that inside of the question is that, is there any software which can be customized by the other people? And software, you have got an IPR and that can be given to the other STD?
Yes, yes.
Something
yes.
like that?
Yes, yes.
There you charge the fee?
Yes.
So customization will be at their cost?
Yes, yes. That's correct.
Well, I have two quick questions. One is that when somebody from abroad, they must be paying in hard currency, dollar, etc. How do you account?
No, typically what they do is they access the system. Okay. And we
the
also...
credit card. Because
credit card facility is there.
So in a foreign country, he will use the credit card of that country, which will access to his bank account, which is hard currency, dollar.
No, No, typically what happens is that they get in touch with our agents. In the website, we also have agents. Typically, they get in touch with our agents, and then they do the transactions.
They do that.
The people based in based here do the transactions for them, so that when they come here, everything is ready, and you can take your ticket.
Okay. And second short question is that, are you going to extend these facilities to Nimadi centers and other centers?
Pneumatic centers?
No, Nimadi. Your Nimadi service.
Oh, yeah.
Nimadi.
Yeah. That's called as Nimadi.
Nimadi.
Nimadi is contentment.
Nimadi.
Okay. Yes, certainly. In course of time. We want to take off, I mean, make use of all the government channels also for this.
Bangalore, you have already done.
Correct. Bangalore 1 I mentioned. Bangalore 1 is basically a city-based system.
Yeah.
Okay. So now they started with Bangalore. Now they have started covering other district centers also. In course of time, the smaller places also will be covered. Okay. Probably Nemadi could be one of the channels.
Yeah, any other questions? Shall we ask the next presenter to come?
So we should give a hand to the beautiful application.
Thank you.